Hello, welcome to another exciting online class with Miss Stella Maris. How have you been? I hope you practiced your last. How many of you were able to go through the video? And how many of you tried your voices? You have to keep doing your voice therapy, so at the end of the day, you become perfect by the day. Sing for daddy or sing for mommy, so they will hear you and give you their physical scars. But today we are moving on to another exciting one. It's called a musical instrument. How many of you know that we have lots of musical instruments? We have them classified into various categories, like the percussion, the wind, we have the strings, we have the woodwind, we have the brass. Some of them you have to blow air into them, some you have to beat, some of them you have to strike, and some of them you have to bowl. But today we are going to be looking at a woodwind instrument, which is called a tin whistle. The tin whistle, also known as the penny whistle, is a six-hole bored instrument. It has the tube, it has the mouthpiece, and it has holes. All tin whistles are majorly six holes, and they are of different keys. But today I have just two with me. But I'm going to be teaching you on one, because that's the one I know you can take better. C major T whistle is the easiest. And for starters, we prescribe that you use the D major T whistle. But for your class, I want to take you up to this. I have this T whistle here. It has the mouthpiece, which is this blue part, then we have the tube, and we have the holes. This is called the mouthpiece, and in this mouthpiece I believe you can see a hole. This hole here is called the airflow, or you call it a window. When it is closed, you will not hear any sound. Now listen. But once I take the finger out or off, you hear the sound. That's the sound you get from the F major. But on the D major, this is the sound. This is the easiest to learn about. But before we go right into that, I want to tell you how we are going to use our fingers, because it has rules. We have two hands comprising of five fingers each. Now, I want to quickly tell you the names of your fingers. We have this as our thumb, finger 1. Finger 2 is the pointer. Finger 3 is the tall man. Finger 4 is the ring man. And finger 5 is the pinky. We call this the ring man because I know you and I, daddy, mommy, you see people, they wear their rings here. That's why it's called the ring man. But on both hands, we are going to be using three fingers each. Which three fingers are we supposed to use? On my left hand, I'm going to use finger 2. That's what? The pointer. Finger 3, the tall man. And finger 4, the ring man. On both hands, you have to take three out. Now, your left hand is always on top of the tea whistle, and while your right hand supports the other holes. Now, let's give it a try. If you're having yours, I need you to hold it up high. Can you see the holes? Now, this is my left hand, but you looking at me, you'll be seeing it as if it's my right hand. So make sure you are sitting the way I'm sitting and take your left hand to hold your tea whistle. Now, I'm holding this by the bottom. Looking at the holes, I have first hole, I'll put my first finger, second hole, the third hole. Why the thumb and the pinking stays behind the tin whistle. The same way I come here and I do the same thing. Now my six holes are properly covered. You must allow the flesh of your fingers go across the holes, else it will blow a wrong sound. Now listen to this soft sound. I want to blow just one. That's Let's take it again. Now we are going to the next one because we have the scale as do, re, mi, fa, sol, do, si, do. So quickly, I'm going to take the first one, do, re. You take the first finger from the bottom out. You gradually build it. You go to the next one. The next one. The next one. Then to get your T, you open all holes out. Then you get the last do. Remember, it is seven letters or seven scale so far. But to get the eighth one, is always a repeat of the first, which is do. So you put all your fingers together and open the very first finger from the top. Now do it. Are you seeing it? Yeah. Then you blow it, adding more strength than the one you've been using. So we want to quickly run it together. I hope you're practicing. We have to do this together because in our next class, we are going to be using the steel whistle to play a song. So now let's go. Class, I gave you a song. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Okay, I'm going to help you with the first two lines since we are already learning this. So let's quickly take this one that we have learned in this lesson to strike a balance to our last class. So quickly, this is do and it's what? Do, do, so, so, la, la, so. Sing it with me. Do, do, so, so, la, la, so, fa, fa, mi, mi, re, re, do. So this is do, re, mi, fa, so. So becomes two fingers, la, one finger, fa, three fingers, mi, four fingers, re, five fingers, and do, six fingers. So let's try it. Do, do, so, so, la, la, so. We'll do that. Can we take it again? Go. How did you find her? I hope it was very interesting. All right, till I come your way again, I need you to keep practicing, and keep practicing because we are going to be going on other songs that will be fun, exciting. Any song you see and you know the so far, pick up your tea whistle and make sure you give it a try. Ciao.